some really, really strong hitboxes. And on top of that, some really, some decent frame data as well, too, man. Definitely looking the best of the three species, that's for sure.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like there's definitely it's a little contest right now between Fox and Wolf. But I think that Wolf is probably the easier of the three to pick up and do well with as a top player. Like, if you have that top player mentality, man, just transfers over so easy for you. Not to say that Fox obviously doesn't, but it's just, I mean, Wolf seems to have a tool for everything, you know? And a little farther behind that, obviously, is Falco. But, you know, Falco's still nice in this game, just not he's not up there with the big boys.
That's right, man.
Yeah, man. The big boys in the top tier, he'd be in high tier just like, hey, man, I'll be up there one day.
I'll be up there one. He knows his place, man. Hopefully these patches bless him. So he can get more people.
He's like, wait till my neutral air is nice. nicer than this, you know?
Right.
It's nice, but it ain't. I'm just going to hop out of shield all the time with it nice.
Yeah, man. Wolf's Nair is like hopping out the bando, dog. I mean, he doesn't need much incentive. I mean, opens up the door. Here we are, man.
Pokemon Trainer versus Mega Man. I don't know. You know, Leffen has been on Twitter pretty much before all of his matches. Like, yo, who's trying to practice? I need to play. I don't know what Mega Man practice he was going to be able to find out here. Yeti probably the only. He doesn't want this. Is that? I mean, I think he just signaled he didn't.
Uh-oh.
Yeah,
wait a second.
It's quick button check. All right. Yeah, he looked back to some people. Was like, yeah, we're not playing yet. So, but yeah, I don't know if he got a chance to play. So, is he coming in this cold? Is he just going to learn the matchup on the fly? I think a lot of people do when they're playing up against Mega Man.
That's right. But
he's not a common character.
I will say though that, you know, Leffen is a top player amongst many different, not iterations of Smash, just many different games. Of course, you know, obviously you and I dabble a bit in DBZ.
Yeah.
He's, you know, very strong showing in there as well. Of course, he played a little bit of Smash 4 at the beginning. Diddy Kong was okay, but of course, you know, what really put him on the map was how great he played in Melee. But no matter what game you're good in, it has to take research. So even though he hasn't played against a Mega Man, I'm sure he's very well aware of what this character can do, and I'm sure he's very well aware of what Yeti has done in Smash Ultimate as well. It's kind of hard to tune into any Smash Ultimate VOD on YouTube and not see any Yeti footage.
Yeah. That's actually super true, man. My boy's been kind of tearing it up with this Mega Man late. Speaking of Mega Man, what I want to know what happened to Plup. I actually think to see the rest of his results.
You're right, yeah.
So, yeah. I know Plup, I've been here with the Mega Man. I know he was messing with the Ridley for a little bit. So, but yeah, I gotta go check the Smash GG bracket to see where Plup ended up. He was one of the other top players that I think had a chance of getting into this top eight. It was him, Armada, and of course, Leffen out here.
Yeah.
And Leffen was would have been my first bet, obviously.
Oh, come on now, yeah.
Right. And even with Armada out here training with the Loft a lot, Leffen, it's just the way that he understands this game is crazy. So here we are getting right into our first game between our two competitors.
Alrighty. Leffen switching to Squirtle first. You know, we've seen a few different combinations with who he decides to start off with, but more times than not, you're going to see the Squirtle or the Ivysaur first to put on the damage, and then depending on how things go, he'll use Charizard to kind of clean up his play.
Oh, damn.
He's slicing this man up.
Oh, yeah. I mean, at least you're looking a lot better in this game, I'll tell you that.
Yeah.
All right, so Leffen, I think Leffen just wanted to get his guaranteed damage. There it is. Got the 51 off the I think it was like dash attack straight up.
All right, man, we got two grass types. Meeting right here on Pokemon.
Yeah, we about to find out who really do got the best Razor Leaf right here.
Here
so
we go.
Leaf Shields again.
Toss it out at him here. Hangs on to the ledge. And I think Yeti's very well aware of what Leffen likes to do at the ledge. A lot of times Leffen will either go for drop off and then use his up special Vine Whip through the ledge so he can try to get the sweet hit to knock you away. And so that way he was like, I'm just going to retreat with Lemons.
Hey, wow, Leffen trying to get that grab. Wasn't even to get it. I don't know how much practice Leffen ever got against a projectile like this, man. Lemons is a very interesting thing. It's like it kind of reminds you, obviously, of the Falco laser with like the quick hit style, but it's just how you get hit with them so often, how quickly it comes out. I think it throws a lot of people off, thinking, oh, he's about to land on me. Let me see if I can get an up smash or something. The next thing you know, you're lemoned out.
Oh, nice stuff. It's a very extremely high recovery right there. My man was sharking from upper knee flip. Speaking of sharking, Yeti looking to do the same, but Leffen, though, that up smash, man, cleaning up my man Yeti real quick here.
So now I know that like Yeti he is at the low percent of this, he can still get these low percent combos. But I am a little shook of seeing Squirtle here at this low percent. He gets two withdrawals and just calls it out, or then withdraws that man actually.
Yeah,
he's like, yeah, we got the three piece right here.
Okay, there's a Razor Leaf. Okay, I don't expect him to get too many Razor Leaf confirmations with Ivysaur, and it's only because Mega Man plays the long range game as well too. You know, it's really easy to get that stuff on characters like Wolf, characters like Fox, Pichu, characters that have to be up close and personally. But Mega Man, if he has to stay on one side of stage and just shoot stuff at you, trust me, he'll do it too.
Wow. Now, right there, man, Leffen actually almost calling that jump yet again with that Vine Whip as he was about to hop off the platform. Luckily for Yeti, the higher platform was able to get him up and away from that Vine Whip.
There it is.
Looks like these guys definitely gonna be throwing some blades right here. One metal, one razor.
Okay. Nice try to go for the fast fall forward air. couldn't quite make magic happen. Leffen holding on to the stage, and we see him get a lot of mileage off that in some of the earlier games here today, but a good patience right there from Yeti as he decides to get up off the ledge a little bit more safe than some of the people we've seen earlier. Get that hard knuckle out of here.
Okay, he was there. Just I'm not sure if he fully believed in it.
Yeah, but yeah, looked like he reacted just a little too late to Yeti's roll.
Oh, no.
Oh, my God, it's genius. I was like, man, he might be off the top right here, but the swap just to go ahead and get himself a little bit of invincibility so he didn't get hit that last hitbox so he wasn't launched off the top.
Yes.
And now he's back on the Ivysaur. Of course, he's probably trying to figure out a way to get this. Oh, hold up.
That swipe, yeah, man. Oh, what you doing out there? Okay, good stuff. Anytime he messes up his recovery option with Ivysaur, he switches right to Charizard because he knows Charizard has the armor but stuffs out that flare blitz. My man Yeti holding on to the lead here for dear life. Leffen is trying to regain it.
I feel like sometimes Leffen likes to get a little bit too wild with that side B or the flare blitz. Yeah, sometimes he's like, you know what, let me just see if you're looking. But he always dies for it, so. Either way, though, still keeping it close. 13% here on the Ivysaur. Is he going to try to swap it up? Oh, my God, here we go, big time. That's what I'm saying. It doesn't matter who he starts off with. As long as it's one of Ivysaur's four, he's going to get the big damage right at the beginning. Almost got the vine.
That's
whip.
Right.
God, look at the...
Oh, no, he did not.
He carried this whole stock with that character. God damn.
Did he
not get a good god damn?
Good Lord Jesus, TK. Take him to church now.
All right. I wonder why Leffen just doesn't start with that all the time. Why he doesn't just start with the Ivysaur all the time. I mean, his Squirtle is nice, but the Ivysaur literally does the damage and takes the stocks all in like three interactions.
Yes. The difference is, I think he just needs that. He needs certain setups with Ivysaur, where with Squirtle, obviously, he's a little bit more free to use his footwork, run in and out, and just kind of run circles around the opponent. But, man, I have to agree with you, man. With the way he's playing with his Ivysaur, I want to see some more of that, all right?
Well, it's good to keep mixing up his opponent, too, obviously. That's the true power of Pokemon Trainer. It's three matchups you got to learn on the fly when I decide for you to learn them.
There, okay? It is. That's right.
You know what? I want to play this character now. What you doing?
That's right, man. Unlike Olimar, man, where he's kind of three, a couple characters in one, two, you get to dictate when your characters are switched in and out. Okay?
Okay. Oh, the back air actually hitting the ground. Not sure if he got the last back hit that he needed. So, and this Squirtle actually just straight up kicking through the pellets, gets the down air. Oh, I think he wanted to push him back to the other side of the stage, but still.
Okay, trying to push him off the stage, though. Yeti with that good landing option there with the hard knuckle. Okay, a pressure from up close. Not a lot of damage put on the board here for both of these two characters. Obviously, they're playing the slow-paced game here. I like it. They're just kind of chiseling away at each other, working each other's nerves here. Oh, wait. No.
Nope, we got the left swap. We good. Or the sweet swap, as you call it. The recovery is never over.
That's right.
as long as he's allowed to do the up B into the swap, yeah.
Said it ain't over till it's over, baby. Oh, now you knew better to try to shore you than me, man.
All right, it's damage right there. Oh my God, he passed it to him too. He said, "Yo, take this. It's your crash bomber, sir. I found this and I lost a foul."
Right. I said, "I think this belongs to you."
Hey, I thought Leffen was actually going to go for the up smash instead of the forward smash, but looking at the percentage, the up smash probably good to just kind of force him off stage instead of wasting a fresh up smash if it wasn't going to KO.
Things aren't looking pretty right here for my man Leffen here, but the same could be said here for Yeti. Leffen really struggling here to find this setup. He's using a lot of Razor Leafs because
should be good.
Character
all right,
switch.
There it is.
Right, back onto this. He's going to flare blitz this time. Not at all, man. He's met with the forward air from my man Yeti.
Yeah, well, Yeti actually hitting all of the Pokemon with their own elements, man. That forward air coming out to hit a fire Pokemon. He's like, "Oh, you on grass? Let me use this leaf shield. What's up?"
Wait, man, is this Mega Man or Avatar? I don't know what the heck is going on. But I tell you what, I like the Mega Man movie better than the Avatar movie, that's for sure.
Wait, this is a Mega Man movie?
It don't even need to be a movie. Anything's better than the Avatar movie. I'm sorry.
I'm going to have to go look that up. Leffen actually getting his stock off, though. Staying on to the Ivysaur. You know, we saw what he did with his solo Ivysaur on that last stock against Yeti the first time, so. I don't want to count him out by any means. Gets the Razor Leaf, but does not get the grab.
Not at all. Definitely has his work cut out for him, though, that's for sure. Okay, nice. Crosses out the leaf shield. Oh, nice.
A quick 50.
The double upper. Oh, whiffs the grab. Doesn't take any damage, though, from it. I like it. You know, even though Ivysaur is known for playing the long-range game, he doesn't mind getting up close on Mega Man.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Yes, you're able to get that.
Oh, no.
Wow, he's way too low for that. I'm not sure why he didn't try to go for another up B. But, yeah, he just swapped it. Maybe thought he had the correct distance calculation, but just a little too low for Charizard to grab that ledge. We got the swap over to swap over to Ivysaur, the back air, and then hits him with a little bit of extra with the side of leg moving.
Thank you, leg. Man, yeah, you know, when you play up against a character like Pokemon Trainer, you got to make sure that, you know, if your combo isn't confirmed, that you're in a good position to use this combo safely. Because if it's not a confirmed combo, I'm going to be able to switch my Pokemon out of it. As you see right there, it switches to a big body, getting hit with a lot of swirlies here.
Okay, yep, just fourth throw, get him off stage. Not going to waste any time right there.
Okay, no left. Trump puts himself in a really weird position. Toss out the up air. Going to switch all back over to Squirtle.
I actually charged up a little bit. Oh, okay. He needed that. He's living. And he had a jump still. Okay, well, we got the Ivysaur out. Again, we saw what the Ivysaur is doing, but I also see what a Yeti is doing right now, and he is locking him out.
Okay, nice.
How is he going to get back to the stage? That's what we need to know. Gets the recovery this time. Rolls on, but Yeti all over him.
There's the hard knuckle once more there. TK
hard
met with the back
air. Hard life. Jesus. My man Leffen having a hard time just getting hit. Man, he took so much damage just trying to get back on that stage. So many saw blades or metal blades, so many hard knuckles. Oh, too much being thrown at him.
Yeah, he had to use every tool in Mega Man's arsenal to get that taken because, you know, when you switch to Charizard off the ledge, if he doesn't flare blitz and you run up and try to shield grab him, he's just going to toss out up smash. Mm-hmm. He's going to try to send you to the oblivion every time. Wow. Such strong intellectual gameplay here from both of these two players. You know, the two characters that they play are not easy characters to play at all, man. Mega Man definitely going to take some big brain stuff. The same can be said for Pokemon Trainer as well, too. Mm-hmm. So the fact that they're able to perform like this at this level in front of this huge audience, as I look behind me, everybody in the room just about
is stacked up right now,
man. Play.
It is stacked up. I mean, obviously some great action going on to the body, onto the main screen as well. But if you're watching this one, we appreciate you rocking out with the Black Order. Anyway.
Right, the Black Order. Sorry, yeah.
Leffen, Yeti, into game of three here.
Uh-oh.
As I like to call it, the flex game, because if there is a game five, whoever won game three, is they're getting their counter pick, so at least they get to play on their terms, their controls. But,
yeah, it's going to be certainly hard, though, to make that happen for both of these two players. We have the platforms here to kind of aid some of our combos, probably more specifically thinking about Ivysaur. That short hop, fair, low percents can chain into a couple uppers if the opponent's not careful. Mega Man's pretty easy guided combo.
And this is the biggest thing about this matchup, too, is just, you know, not being frustrated by Mega Man.
Yeah.
Because, like, this could be a very frustrating game. Oh, there it is again. This is a very frustrating game. Oh, my God. What is going on with my headset? Police. This is a very frustrating gameplay as far as dealing with this Leaf Shield on you all the time, man. It is rough.
That's right. It can be certainly frustrating for both of the two competitors here. And this is only Ivysaur, which is the crazy part about this. You know, the meta can certainly switch up at the drop of a hat. If as soon as the combo isn't confirmed, we're going to see Squirtle. We're going to see, we're going to have to see Charizard now.
Damn, y'all good? Like, boy, he's over here slapping the projector over here, bro. Nice. Who was that?
They getting hyped, man. They getting hyped for their boy. This ain't Florida, man. Oh, my God. He said, this ain't the right stage either, dog. You must have thought you was going to be able to roll up on this stage for free. Nah, son, here's the forward smash.
Yeah, man, every time Yeti lands, he gets that Leaf Shield out and he gets that damage on it as well. Look at that. Hey, even if he throws it the wrong way, I just feel like Leffen is still kind of in a position where he's a little shook or not so readily on the punish that, you know, he gets away with it.
Most certainly.
Yeah, take this. You got to get out of here yet again. Uh-huh. He's been doing quite well of kicking through these pellets and stuff with this Squirtle, but I like the swap. Okay, still
swap.
Got hit, though.
That's right. Swap right into some hitboxes, though. You got to swap a little safer than that. Okay. More Leaf Shield. Uh-oh, the pressure up underneath. I talked about it being good for Ivysaur, but it's also good for Mega Man. He cannot jump.
You cannot jump out of that, man. That is exactly how you hit that blast on way earlier than expected. What pressure, though, did Yeti putting on as he was straight up just tornadoing that man up?
That's right. Leffen is learning things he never knew. He never knew, man.
Now I think about it. You know, flying types have an advantage on grass. So.
Well, that's it. That's true. Let him know, TK.
He flew out that game. I'll tell you that.
All right, Pokemon Company, hire us, all right? I'm just saying, man. We know a thing or two about a thing or two. So do both of these two gentlemen. That's why they're here right now, rocking and rolling with us here now. Leffen right now coming from a very interesting spot, man. Up underneath Yeti right now, trying to get the style taken from off top. He's not switching to Charizard, man. He thinks he can get it done with Ivysaur, and I kind of believe in it.
Okay, the F smash, but from across the stage, not going to be enough. The double jump. Oh, I like that. He's trying to cover the platform with the up air. I think that would have been able to take the stock, but uh-oh. Off stage, yeah, that's what we need, the low recovery. Every time he's been going high, he's been taking that, he's been taking that back air, so.
Oh, nice. Okay, look at, do you see the patience from Leffen? Do you see the patience before your very eyes?
All right, swapped over. Okay, yeah, we got to get through there. Leffen swapping over to the Squirtle. I'm a little shook at this, but I know he thinks he can at least get that first piece of damage going from watching Watch yourself yet again. Oh, my. Look at the damage he's adding up with the Leaf Shield. Gets the grab here. This is what he was looking for. Oh.
It's just time to shine. Using these platforms as advantage. Don't even think about getting off of there, good sir. This one, one of the later hitboxes of the back. The hard knuckle forces the switch.
Okay,
don't
he's
jump.
Out.
Don't jump.
Yeah, well, he could jump because he jumped away from it this time. He didn't jump straight into it, so. Almost got him again. I'm not sure if I don't think he's getting the sweet spot, so therefore he's not getting the strong hitbox of that. Yeti said, you know what? Let me just get out of here. Watch out. Leffen.
Hold on.
Bad good. All the way to the left side.
Okay, fall away fair. Hold him on the ledge. I love the conditioning. So smart. You got to watch the corners, the cracks, the crevices on every stage.
I like the little pellet he put in there as well. Oh, yeah. What is y'all doing?
All right.
What is you doing? Oh, no. All right, man. We having some projector difficulty out here. People out here.
Hold on. You don't want to make this crowd upset. You don't want to make this crowd upset.
No.
You don't look.
Can we fix that, please?
All right, man. I might need security.
Listen, this my job is over here, and I'm somehow trying to troubleshoot everything too.
I'm trying to let my boy in.
Here we go. Let's just see if he's able to fix it in time, man. Some technical difficulties here on the on our part of the thing. Hey, there we go. We back.
That's right, man. The match is so crazy. I ended up throwing the projector out. All right.
Yeah.
I wish you guys could see the camaraderie in this room, man. I wish you guys could feel the electricity. Hopefully, it translates very well over into the chat because I'm definitely feeling it in my bones, dude.
Definitely feeling my bones, man. Feel it in my soul.
Yeah, man.
This top eight is going to be explosive. It's going to be a great show tomorrow, but right now we got to see who's even making it to this top eight, man. That's some real competition being had here on this Genesis side stage, man.
Okay. Moving to the next game, man. Just a very heart-clenching finish there in that last one here, but Yeti right now is the one leading, and actually we are on Unova of all stages, interesting enough. But like you said, sometimes Unova's looked at as the necessary evil, man, so you can get what you want afterwards.
Yeah, but I mean, I like this stage.
No, so it's not a bad stage at all.
Yeah, but I mean, if we were talking about, for obviously the, like if it was a counterpick, like a hard counterpick for you because your character teleports or something else just you don't like about the stage, say the platform being too high, sometimes you got to take that necessary evil, man. There's no way you're going to get them all out the stage, so you just got to get the ones that you definitely don't want to play.
Oh, do you see the footwork there, TK?
Yeah.
Let's talk about comfortability in the matchup. Yes, he is moving. Let's talk about comfortability in the matchup, man. We use that Leaf Shield as well as Yeti does. You know this matchup like the back of your hand. Okay, good stuff. Electing the switch really quick in the Vine Whip.
Yeah, he's Tarzaning back into this stage. Hold up.
Georgia the jungle with it.
Yeah, this time, the hard knuckle every time. Leffen seemed like he's waiting for him to land, but he's not going to land without the hard knuckle coming out.
Okay, once more up close. Looking to put the pressure on up close here. Using the lemons. Retreating lemons at that to conditioning the opponent.
Uh-uh. Leffen is trying to find these forward airs in here. But I'm surprised he's still on the Squirtle this early on. I mean, he already has the damage that he's looking for on this first stock. He just needs to find the KO.
Forward air. Once more. Oh, nice. Use the forward tilt right up on the top platform. I think he thought that Yeti was going to try to jump up and limit him some more.
Oh, okay. There it is.
Damn. Okay. Once more off stage. Okay. Oh, no hard knuckle for you that time.
Yeah, not at all. Here we go. Getting some damage as well. Gets the up air and still follows the DI. I think he was a little farther than he probably wanted.
Right.
I want that DI, or probably want that up air to send out so he can get a second one. But
absolutely,
yeah.
Yes. This is definitely Leffen's time to shine here. If he could try to figure out a way to put some more send on, he could kind of cut this thing in half here.
Oh my God. He actually put an entire wall up. He said, look, my boy rushed down here. He boosted me to the top. I know you're trying to get into the club through the back door entrance, but I'm still here.
He said, here's the wall, dog. You don't need no tax money for this, all right? Nice stuff there. More Leaf Shield again up close. And Leffen really, I mean, of all the aspects of this matchup to kind of touch base on, he's really struggling with how well he's doing with Yeti up close and personal. Long range game, doesn't mind it. But up close, though, I don't think he quite knows what to do here.
It's hard, too. Okay, the get up attack. He might have thought he was just close enough. I mean, I feel like that foot barely touched or barely whiffed. Well, here we go.
Oh.
Leffen. I thought he was going to go for it, man. But maybe not believing. Maybe not believing at that percentage.
Okay, man. He's going to have to make a believer out of Yeti here, man. He's going to have to make him believe that he can force this to a game five situation. There's the back air. Uses the final stall. Narrowly escaping the claws of defeat right there. Is he going to switch over to Charizard? Not at all. He said Ivysaur got this one.
Oh, not behind him yet. Okay, gets the down tilt. Okay, gets the grab. What are we doing with that? Not following the DI well enough. Oh, and he does get the down air. Are you trying to recover here? Are you trying to recover here in this area? Absolutely not.
This right here, he said, this square radius right here.
You talking about this? You know what I mean?
This belongs to me, sir.
So living to see another day is Leffen, man. You can see that he is very, obviously he needed to stay in the tournament, but he is very relieved to be able to get another game here against Yeti and possibly take it and move on.
The fact that he's not as comfortable playing against Mega Man, but he's still able to push it to a game five shows how strong of a player that he is, adapting over a series of games. That's something not even some of the best players in the world can do, man.
Yeah.
Okay, Yeti. Yeah, all right, Leffen.
Yeah, Yeti. How did your adjusting going, man? I mean, that was I feel like a game in his bag. But Leffen has been looking for that down air spike quite a bit throughout the set, and the one that hit is the one that matters.
That's right. You're most certainly correct, man. This is it, ladies and gentlemen, for all the marbles right here. There's a lot on the line. The crowd is on the edge of their seat. I'm hearing some Yeti chants. I'm hearing a lot of TSM chants. There must be a lot of subscribers out here in the audience. I don't know, man. They're getting the most out of that $4.99.
All right, let's go ahead and get into our game five here.
That's right. Okay, sticky some real quick there to put some low percent damage on. Oh, walks right up on him, man.
This always happens to be a little bit of a problem, man. Yeti being able to just jump straight on top of him with that leaf shield and put the pressure onto him. There you go. Gets the grab, though. He had already been blocking it, so Yeti, after he threw it, was just kind of stuck. Big damage coming in from left.
It puts you in an awkward position, too, man, because once he walks up on you with that shield, you want to press the button, but you can't. But you also don't want to hold shield because you're going to be forced to get grabbed. It's like, what are you to do?
Yeah. Okay, looking for the F smash. He played a little bit of extra on that score this time. Oh, my God.
Okay, that would have been the read of a lifetime, trying to catch the downswing from the vine whip. Okay, razor leaf, runs right up. I didn't even want it to connect. I just wanted the grab, sir.
Okay, so this time around, he gets the down throw up air instead of the down throw up B. He could have probably still got the vine whip if he would have, held the angles to hit kind of directly above him.
Yes.
But regardless, still some good. Oh, he is very close to catching this Tarzan swing, though.
Okay. Oh, he tried to hard, but Wade is back on him, and then Wade turning a bad situation into a good one. I'm going to need a replay on that, chat. I'm going to need a replay.
I think there's something about the fact that he walked up and put that, the crash bomb on him because it exploded and he was landing from the F tilt. He almost made it, for the up tilt, almost made it safe. That's some tech right there, Yeti.
That's definitely
some tech.
Yes.
If I was a Mega Man player, I'd be stealing that.
Oh, yeah, free. That belongs to me now. Charizard, oh, we're going to punish the... Oh, wait a minute. He said, I got the gat on me. I got the thing on me.
And he said, I know you got the back roll, but I'm still here.
That's right, man. I got a traveling forest mask. Not too many characters. I think he might be the only character in the game with a traveling forest mask.
That's moving that far. I mean, whew.
Yes. All right. And now, speaking of moving right here, man, Squirtle right now moving and grooving across the stage. But he has a lot of room to work with, but yet he decides to stay up close and personal on Yeti because you know you can't play the projectile game with Squirtle.
Yeah, so Leffen make sure he gets all the percent that he can off of his Squirtle play. Before he decides to swap out.
Uh-oh. Okay, once more with the forward air. Yes, has to get the most out of each character. Okay, some very interesting platform pressure from up underneath. I do like the attempt.
Oh,
I don't
man.
Know if I like the execution, though.
Okay. I mean, we don't get to see him hit a lot, but that time that was a pretty spot-on one. And the great spacing just kind of moves away a little bit, and then a slap. Take that, boy. That's yours now. That's my stock now, boy.
Uh-oh.
Don't want to count Yeti out, though, man. Yeti. Obviously, I mean, a great player in his own right. He got all the way to this game five, and he was on the winner of the flex game. So this is his chance, man. This is his shine.
Mm-hmm. Okay, gets hit with the last hit of the back here right there. Forza Moss stays. Doesn't go for the gear at all. It's gone. There's the – okay. Limic almost stopped him in his tracks.
Okay, hold up. We're getting some back airs.
Oh, he's cooking.
Oh, I think that DI down or the air dodge down actually got Yeti out of a couple more back airs. So very smart from him. Oh, and the swap. Okay.
Oh, wait a second. Hold on. He got something on him. He got something he shouldn't have on him.
I feel like that might have saved him, no real rap.
Yes.
Yeah, that explosion seemed to have pushed him away instead of getting forward air by Yeti right there.
Uh-oh.
But finish that stock.
Okay, he knows it wasn't going to be able to work for that time. Throw. Uh-oh. Throw. See ya. Oh, but wait.
I thought he was going to go for the up throw there. Either way, wow. And now the weak hit of the forward air is still not enough to finish. Leffen going to go ahead and air dodge back to the ledge. Up throw this time, maybe? Nope, forward throw.
Wait, forward throw again? Is he just trying to keep him off stage?
I mean, maybe there might be something I'm missing about this. I thought up throw did kill, though. Could be wrong, man. Mega Man players will be like, that's not a thing.
And you're
I'm
right,
like, you're right.
No, we wish it was a thing, though.
Yeah.
Okay, the Razor Leaf. Keeping him at bay here. Oh, okay. Wait a minute. Only 74% on board right now. I got some Minnesota brethren to the right of me. They're about to pop off for the boy if he can make this happen. Leffen looking to stop it. Oh, did you just try to force smash my shield?
Yeah, I don't know if that was the play right there. And so 44% Leffen, not getting a single hit with this Squirtle yet, but definitely getting chased down. Hold up, Yeti looking extra good on this last stock. Leffen finally getting a hit, but I mean, it's not enough for him to be able to go over there and get that
bite. Wait a minute.
Oh, I thought he jumped into it for a second. I got you.
Oh, he turn around! That's what I'm talking about. That's a